once again. Oh dear. The Bungalow has something new. So don't be surprised if you hear them shout.
Oh, wait, I'm not inside out.
The Bungalow.
Morning.
And now, boys, and say this.
I'm a really good singer, and you are not.
Hark! Is that the Bungalow heads I can hear?
Welcome, Perver.
Oi.
Welcome, Perver, age 7 from Southall.
Hello.
Perver loves ice cream soup. And Perver really loves dressing up. She once dressed up as a strawberry. You won't believe this, but we found a strawberry that wanted to dress as you. Fruity.
Patch.
Here's Akash, age 12, also from Southall.
Hello.
Akash likes scaring people.
Yeah.
He also likes telling people they're wrong. Is that right?
No, that's not right. That's wrong.
See what we mean? Crackers. And Akash loves digging up holes so people fall in them. We've got a treat for you. Nice.
Bear.
It's Dalraj, age 10, from Southall.
Hello.
Dalraj has got a funny laugh. That is mildly funny. By the time Dalraj is 20, he wants to be a multi-millionaire.
Who wants to be a millionaire?
Dalraj!
Dalraj loves funfair rides. The scarier, the better.
Bear Bob.
Hello, Sanjay, age 12 from Greenford.
Hello.
Sanjay loves tools. He likes throwing a spanner in the works and hammering it home. Has he got a screw loose? Sanjay has got a dance which he made up when he was 3 and thought was brilliant. Take it away. Wow, that's supernova.
2.
Look, it's Amadeep. He's 11 and from Southall too.
Hello.
Amadeep loves getting mushy.
Yeah.
Amadeep loves catching grasshoppers.
Yes, I do.
Uh-oh, you might be in trouble here. It's a grasshopper that likes catching kids.
Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4.
5.
There's only 5.
Really?
Just for a change.
That's bizarre.
We usually have 6, don't we?
Who's that?
Hey?
Is that you?
What?
I just heard a...
Now then.
Oops.
It's usually 6. Let's get our celebrity in. You wanted... Will Smith! So we got you! David Grant!
Yeah! Welcome to the Bungalow, David Grant from London! David is from Fame Academy. He's vocal coach to the stars, including Will Young, Take That, and the Spice Girls. He's Carrie's husband, too. David is the first to tell his famous students if they're not cutting it. Please welcome Will Young!
I think you better leave right now!
Rubbish, leave right now!
Welcome!
Go on, take off your coats, take your badges, and throw them over there and don't take a seat.
David, put on your shower cap and take a seat over there.
Look, there he is, the Bungalow heads!
Quick!
Oh, it's a party. Isn't that nice?
Nice silly string.
David!
Nice. Look, yes, David!
David was well prepared. David, yes. What have you got on your head?
What I have on my head is a hair protector.
A hair... Ooh. Why don't we get hair protectors? I want... Can we have a hair protector for next week, please? Thank you very much.
Welcome, bungalow heads, to the bungalow. You're here for a whole Saturday morning till 11 o'clock. You're here to win bungalow points.
Do you know what bungalow points mean? What do they mean?
They mean prizes.
Prizes. She says prizes.
Perva says prizes. Perva prizes.
Oh, crocodile, still throwing up silly string.
Who wants a hot crust nun?
Me.
Yeah, you do. Akash.
Hot cross nun. Third prize, have a look.
Third, look at that. A hot cross nun.
She looks hot and she looks cross and she looks like a nun.
Who wants a second prize?
It's a good one this week.
It's a good one.
Flat screen telly.
Is it? No, it's not.
Who told me it was
a... Let's have a look at it. Is that a flat screen telly?
Yes, it is, but it's coming to a fancy dress party disguised as an MP3 player.
Right, marvellous. And the star prize, Perva. Have a look at the star prize. You wanted the third prize, the second prize, but look at the star prize.
Ooh, look at that, look at that.
This weekend's winning bungalow head will get the experience of a lifetime. It's an amazing skydiving day out. A simulated skydive at Milton Keynes. And to top it off, we're giving you a digital camera to take pickies of your day. You'll be the envy of all your skydiving wannabe mates.
Oh. Wow, who wants to be a skydiver? David, would you like to go skydiving?
Yes.
Have you been before?
No.
Well, you can't ever do it anyway, even if you win, because you've got to give your first prize to them, to everybody at home. If they phone in to enter competition, then you could win the prize courtesy.
Right. I shouldn't really keep asking you questions, but you're little. Stand up, you're little, aren't you? You're little.
Oh.
And the rest of you, stand up. You're massive. Look at them all. Bigger than you, mate.
Doesn't say much.
Yes. Right, first task. Make up a new one. Show them the dick.
Yes.
He's Cardiff.
Dick and Domtree.
Penny each as well. Make up a new word.
Dick and Domtree.
Make up a new word and tell us its meaning. But whatever you do, do not be
Rudy.
Rudy. You can join in with the bungalow this morning, as always. Call us, text us, email us.
Oh, the prize idiot has the prize.
Hello, he's our next door neighbour, by the way. He lives next door and he's an absolute idiot.
Has he got new eyebrows?
Look,
he's been
green.
They're
Tom Selleck style, aren't they?
Very Tom Selleck
style. What have you been up to? How's it been your week?
Yes. Oh, my week's been mean.
Oh, no. Got it.
It's flying.
Got it.
No, you haven't.
You've got it.
Well, you haven't.
I think he's got it.
I bet you're wondering
where it was made.
Oh, you could be.
I'm wondering what it is.
Oh, I'll tell you. It's a match made in
Devon.
Yes.
Oh, did I get that wrong? Is it Devon?
No, it's
Heaven.
Heaven!
Oh, thank you.
Made in Heaven. Where's the music gone? Oh, thank you. It pinged off because you said Devon. And you spoilt it.
Ruined it.
Like a nasty, grumpy little carpet dwarf that you are.
Apologise to the prize idiot for spoiling his joke.
But it's okay, because right now he's going to think of an even better one, so it doesn't matter. Devon, go.
A joke about Devon.
A joke about Devon. Very creamy.
Very creamy? Quite good so far.
Morning.
It's a set of doggy culottes.
Doggy culottes? Yeah, oh, 090-11-900-500. Ask permission, Dar, carefully. And email prize and text prize.
What is that?
It's a single to Bristol Temple Meats.
No, it's not, you idiot. It looks like a sweet shooter thing.
Sweet
marshmallow shooter.
Bungalow.bbc.co.uk. 5 of them to give away. Or 6 Desmond Tutu. Desmond Tutu.
That looks great.
And your message.
Text us. Email us.
We want to hear from you today.
We want a record amount of emails and texts.
Send us a joke about Devon.
Yeah?
Have you got one?
What about the magic tractor from Devon?
Oh, yeah. There once was a magic tractor.
From Devon.
It turned into a field.
Magic tractor.
Oh, yes. Very good.
It turned into a field.
You don't even get my joke.
No.
You haven't even got your own.
Not funny.
Match made in Heaven.
Thank you. Go next door. See you later.
Here we go.
Job you've been doing this week.
We're going to have this on show the whole time.
Are we?
So that you can text us.
Why don't you stick
things
it to yourself then? On his new shirt. There we are. Have you got your
Nick
and Dobbsbury? Akash. Yeah. Come on up then, Akash. Up here, tell us your word. What is it?
Scarabophagus gustatus.
My word. Could you repeat that?
Scarabophagus
Dickopopamus.
Yes, lovely. And what's that mean?
It means a mummy-like octopus called Dick kisses coughing people.
There we are. A mummy-like octopus
called Dick
kisses... coughing... point.
Well done. 100 bungalow points for you.
100? That's good. Dalraj. Good morning.
Dalraj.
You've got a long one as well. Read it.
Gabba labba
shabba. Boys and girls, would you like to see the word too?
They would.
Gabba labba shabba dabba ding dong.
Gabba labba shabba dabba ding dong.
What's that say at the bottom?
Chocolate.
Chocolate yum.
And what does gabba labba shabba dabba ding dong mean?
It means a dog that comes and eats all our chocolates.
A dog that comes and eats all our chocolates. Marvellous, that's lovely. Any points for that? 80 bungalow points. What was that one on the back you were trying to write? What's that say? Gabba labba dabba ding dong. Marvellous.
Oh, what's that?
What does that dog do?
What does that dog do?
It comes and steals my underpants.
It comes and steals your underpants.
Lovely. Thank you, Dalraj.
Where the chocolate eating one.
Sanjay's next. You like your long words, you lot, don't you? What's that say?
Inkle, finkle, dinkle, do.
I like this one.
Inkle, finkle, dinkle, do.
Meaning?
No worries.
Oh, I like that.
Inkle, finkle,
hey,
dinkle, do.
Inkle, finkle, dinkle, do.
It means now inkle, finkle, dinkle, do.
For the rest, of your...
Yeah, let me get the points.
Yes, 68.
68? Nice.
Inkle, finkle, dinkle, do.
Everyone,
she's a tiny lady.
How do you know all these big people?
Because they're my friends.
They're your friends.
Lovely. And what's your word, pervert?
Chimimimi.
I beg your pardon?
Show to everyone.
Chimimimi.
Chimimimi. And what, are you a chimimimi? What is a chimimimi?
It means someone that eats their dinner out of a public toilet.
Eats their dinner out of a public toilet? What, like a couple of slices of bread?
You know what, you look at her, butter wouldn't melt, would you? And there she is, talking about potty mouth behaviour.
That'd be horrible, wouldn't it? How many points?
We don't condone that, by the way. No. We do condone it. No, we don't.
Points for perva. Perva points.
Go on then. 102 bungalow points.
Chini, mini, 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 mini. Armadeep. Is that you say it? Armadeep?
Yep.
Brilliant.
Armadeep.
Oh, you've crossed one out in the back. What was your word going to be?
I was
going to
write it again.
Oh, okay. Oh, there it is.
Oh, yeah, there it is again, of course.
Okay. The word is bum chicka fungus.
And what is bum chicka fungus?
It's fungi growing on your bum.
The fungi growing on your bum?
Yes.
Wow, a bum fungus. Bum fungus.
Mouldy bum.
Yes.
Bum fungi.
Fungi'd on your
fungi
bum.
Fungi bum.
Bum.
A mushroom riddled butt.
Bum.
A fungi bummy.
Bum.
Fungi bum, 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 fungi bum.
Bum.
Well, we like it.
Yeah.
Bum fung.
Bum.
Hey.
Points.
Fungi bum risotto.
Points.
Let's have 89.
89, and finally, David Grant's in the bungalow.
With his wife behind him. Look, give your wife a kiss.
Give your wife a kiss.
Oh,
there she is.
How is she, by the way?
She is wonderful.
Is she watching?
She will be watching, yes.
Oh, that's Carrie.
Lovely.
Hello.
And your word, David?
I've got blue bloop bungawap. Now, the bungawap is a Mesopotamian frog.
Oh.
And
hang on a minute, you're talking to us here. Yeah, we don't know what those big words mean.
Really know about
it's a frog.
Right, oh, that's better.
And the blue blooper is the yellow marking on the back of the frog.
What's he talking about?
Go on. So it's a
blue blooper bungawap.
And that is a Mesopotamian-leaded frog with a yellow back.
Yes. Yellow-backed frog.
101 bungalow points.
101. Hey. That means the winner of this one's Dickinoshi word is perva. Coming up again, perva.
I'm over here.
And your word again was?
Chimimimi.
Chimimimi. So put your word, chimimimi, into the Dickinoshi. And now let's hear that meaning used in action.
Chimimimi. Someone who eats their dinner out of a public toilet. As in, the popular R&B singer Craig David is no fun to have round your house. Don't let him into your toilet with a microwave ready meal because he's a bit of a chimimimi.
You are. All explained in glory. Thank you very much indeed.
That was the way, and now we're going to play what's going to be happening for the next 2 hours here on Dick and Dom on the Bungalow, the nation's favourite Saturday morning programme.
Oh yes, there's going to be no inkle, finkle, dinkle, do, because we've got some fairly odd parents for you.
Indeed, well rhymed. Look at that, Rats and Scatter, probably for the last time ever on your TVs, ever.
Oh, lovely. Even Stevens is back as well. Nice.
For the all. What's that? What is it? Oh, yeah, Strangely Talented. We brought him back last week and it's going to be back again today, the next round.
Another three acts and another Dick and Dom's Dirty Day.
Mind your eyes.
All that and much
much more.
What else more?
What else? Well, look!
Just lots.
They've got them on, haven't they? They're saggy bags!
I've got floppy flannels in a very large size. Watch out for some very irritating giant flies. They really are disgusting, like oily old rags. So call in pest control before they pop your saggy bags.
Pop your saggy bags. There you are. You've got balloons attached to you. Okay, you got your fly swatters as well. Now, basically, what's going to happen is we've got three giant flies. They're going to be coming in here into the bungalow, trying to pop your baggy sacks through your saggy bags. Okay, and you've got to protect your balloons. The one who's got the most amount of protected the balloons after 45 seconds will be the winner. Oh,
150!
How many? 150. However, the one who has the least amount of balloons left after that time will have to pop the balloon of doom. Here they come. Look, here come the flies.
Get back, fly! Get back!
Wait, get back.
One of them's down. One of them's down.
Back.
These are the big flies. Sing, flies!
We are the giant flies and we feast on poopy woo. Our legs are wet and hairy with muscle bars and derricks. So run for your lives or we'll pop your sagging bags.
Your time starts now, get
go! Protect your balloons!
We want to see those saggy bags being popped! They're just all down on the floor.
Is he just going to fall over again?
Do you all need the loo or something? Your time's up. Right, flies. Buzz off.
Very good, mate.
Buzz, buzz.
See you later. Buzz.
Right, and everyone in a line. Let's count.
So line up facing this way. Like this.
Not you.
Not me.
Not you. Armadine, you had 10 to begin with. Now you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 left. Yeah, lovely. And Akash, you got one. You reckon you got 10 left?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, you have.
Well played. Well defended.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 left for Perva.
1, 2, 3.
Turn around.
4, 5, 6, 7.
For Sanjay.
And Dalraj has got 1, 2, 3. Oh dear, he's only got 4.
Oh.
You've got the most popped, haven't you?
Oh dear.
But what's David got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
8? But that means the winner of the 150 points! Yes! It's Arash with a perfect score! Here's the Rio Ferdinand of this game! Here's the defender of his saggy bag! 150 for you, mate!
Oh. What? The Alex Ferguson?
I said the Rio Ferdinand.
Alright, who's the guy that's just left?
Kino.
This is the Kino, because he's just lost. So there we are. Now, everyone else hide behind the sofa. Arash. You didn't protect your balloons very well, did you?
No.
What did I say would happen? What did we say you would have to do?
Throw cream muck at me.
What?
Throw custard at me.
What?
Throw custard at me.
What? No!
No!
We said that you would have to pop something. What would you have to pop?
A balloon.
Of?
Not any old balloon.
Listen, kid. Do you actually watch our show?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Who's he?
Dick.
Who am I?
Dom.
Right, good, you do watch. You've got to pop the balloon. Oh.
Doom.
Here he comes.
Melvin O'Doom! Here he goes! He's the loser! Melvin O'Doom, ladies and gentlemen! It was the balloon of Melvin O'Doom!
You like that?
Melvin O'Doom?
And he's all singing, all dancing. Do you know who Melvin O'Doom is?
Yeah.
Yeah. Who is he?
He's a shabba-labba-ding-dong.
He's a shabba-labba-ding-dong. Oh, he just called you a shabba-labba-ding-dong.
Are you a shabba-labba-ding-dong?
Only on the weekend.
Only on the weekend? Well, it is the weekend, so you are a shabba-labba-ding-dong.
There we are.
Marvellous.
Yeah.
So there we are.
Marvellous.
Well, that was nice.
Why don't you pop off?
Yeah, pop off.
Take care.
Very well, lads. Brilliant.
Did well for us there, didn't you, Nat?
I did. It was my little joke.
Very good. Stop laughing.
Oh.
Oh no, hang on.
Yes. I feel no pain, I'm a fictitious character.
Oh, you don't feel any pain? Oh,
no, no.
That's great then.
No.
He doesn't feel pain!
No, look.
You heard it! You heard it first! Hey, I'm
For three big lies.
He said, look, he doesn't feel this apparently. You get your fingers up his nose and you.
You get to pick a nominal bungalow t-shirt. Go with me.
He's dead anyway.
Over here. Certainly is. Hey, so did you hear me as he was doing that? Yes, three big flies will be holding up a word. If you spot the word, text or email, you win a bungalow t-shirt. Easy as that.
Easy as that.
Easy
flies
as that.
Flies will hold up word. There he is.
I'm not hurt at all. It was all stunts.
Why don't you go make them cheer?
Cheer, you little monkeys! Cheer!
No.
I don't know why I bothered. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Cheer! 3, 2, 1, go!
Marvellous, that's more like it. That's what we like to see. The tape's in. See you in a short one. You're a winner. If your name's Beck Jones from Bridgend in South Wales, you got the T-shirt, Beck.
There you go, Dick and Dom.
Kisses on the
back. And also we put...
Booze. That's the word on the T-shirt. That's the word you spotted.
Nice. Well done.
It's the Kenomina Bungalow on a
Saturday. Oh, yeah.
And the Bungalow.
Yeah.
Not forgetting here this morning, our celebrity guest, David
Grant.
Yeah.
And even Carrie's here on the portrait.
Oh.
Isn't that nice?
Go literally everywhere together.
Look
at his leg. Did you see it go, ladies and gentlemen? Did you see it? Did you see it go?
Can't hang around. Can't hang around. Charlie Cooper from Biggleswade. Here's a picture.
Is that?
Of Giza.
Oh.
This is my dog, Giza. He's in love with Sprat. Get Sprat.
Sprat.
Come on, have a go.
Hold that.
Because whenever Sprat
come
on
here.
The
no,
TV,
Sprat, don't run away.
My dog jumps up and licks it. And now when I say Sprat, he goes bonkers. I wonder if you could ask Sprat out for Giza. It would make his day to be in love.
Sprat?
So,
you dirty girl.
Oi, this dog wants to go out with you. Yeah? What do you reckon about that?
Actually, hang on a minute. Just put that on there. Hang on a minute. Does that work?
Yeah, there you are.
Sprat, what's up in your head?
Will you go out with that? Maybe. Right, you won one of them.
Yes, which is a marshmallow pinger.
Nice.
Well, go on, get rid of it.
Ping it off.
Another chance to win prizes.
1, 2.
Later.
3, 4.
BungalowBBC.co.uk.
BungalowBBC.co.uk.
And the text is... Oh.
6.
It's over there.
Oh, it's there.
It's over there.
It's on the bottom.
Shelf. On the shelf. Go find it.
It's on the bottom anyway. 6222222. PD and your message.
Love.
Email. Text. Thank you.
What?
Lovely. Mom.
Bonjour. Hello. Au revoir. Goodbye. No.
Now you've got a dirty dick, you've made the manners. Ah, ha, ha, they're gonna chase you down the street and scream and rant and
shout. And you make it to the getaway car, no time to stop and chatter. Let's throw some muck about and play splatter scatter.
Have a bit of splat and scatter.
Yes, yes.
We're in the street, we're going to splat and enter.
Yes.
And then you have to decide whether we're going to get away or we're going to get caught.
Hold it, hold it.
Learned it.
How could you? How could you get it off my son's
Are you mad?
The program back is the best one. What's going on?
What program?
We're doing splat and scatter.
Well, I don't care.
Yeah, why not?
Who are you?
That's my son.
Oh, you're...
That's my lovely son.
It's Melvin O'Doom's dad!
It's Melvin's dad!
It's me.
Yesterday star! Yes, I don't believe it.
So when are you going to bring the program back?
Which program?
Mommy. Well, my son said...
Okay. Yeah, can you just put both of your heads together?
Yes. In fact, the boom, boom, boom.
The what?
You know what I'm talking about?
The boom, boom, boom.
Yes. The broom.
We're just going to try something here. Actually, can we just have a single on Daddy O'Doom and a single on Melvin? And just mix between the two, just to see if they really are father and son. So let's just have a look. There we are. Melvin. Daddy!
Yeah.
Melvin. Daddy!
So tell us again, Mr. O'Doom, what do you want to see again?
Well...
Boom, boom, boom.
Boom, boom, boom. That's the best program.
You mean...
Mummy is miserable.
You mean brum, brum, ding, ding, sing, sing!
That's the best one.
Oh. The Midlands are a mighty jolly gang. They like nothing more than singing in their lilting brummy twang. Grab the next double-decker from Digbeth to the Bull Ring to see how many passengers play Melvin O'Doom's
brum, brum, ding, ding. Sing, sing.
Oh. So, as you heard from Mr. O'Doom, Melvin's dad, we have got to play Brum Brum Ding Ding Sing. He wants it back.
Bum Bum Bum.
Bum Bum Bum. Back on the TV.
That's Melvin's mummy.
That's right. Yeah.
All right, then. You going to stay here for it?
Yes, I'll stay.
Okay, right, then. Well, we've got some boys on the line.
How many people on the bus with Melv will sing along with him? Back to that again.
Let's find out. First call. You always do the first call, are you?
Good morning. How are we?
Hello.
Is it Emily?
Hi, Dick and Dom.
Hi, Emily.
Kerry.
How are you?
How are you?
I'm fine.
Do you like the bungalow?
Yeah, I do like the bungalow.
Would you watch it forever if you could?
Yeah, I would watch it forever.
Yeah, well, tough, because we're off in March.
Forever. Here, look, the bungalow heads are here. Have you seen them all? Who's your favourite this morning?
Me. I like all of them.
You like them? Very diplomatic. Very good. Very good. Look, it's Melvin's dad. Look, say hello.
Would you like to say hello?
Hi. Hello. Hi, Melvin's dad.
How are you? Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Are you enjoying the program?
Yeah, I am enjoying the program.
Well done. Well done.
I just want to check something out. This is another way we'll know if it's definitely Melvin's dad. Can we just have some dances? Can you come here, please, Melvin's dad? What we want you to do. Well, first of all, Melvin, come here. Melvin, have a little dance to music. Go on. Go. Dance.
Right, this is Melvin dancing.
Yeah, there he goes. Now, Melvin's dad. Yeah.
It's got to be. And here is Melvin's mum.
Brilliant, right, back to the phones, here we go.
Emily, how many people on the bus will sing along with Melvin?
Five,
okay. There's eight people on the bus today. You said five. Ta. I'll put a name
Joel.
On.
Joel?
Hi, Dick and Dom.
Joel Roberts.
Hey, what did he say?
Hi, Dick and Dom.
How are you?
Hello.
What?
Who's in the background with you? Who's that shouting in the background?
Sister.
You what?
My sister.
Put her on the phone.
Alright.
Sure.
Alright.
Alright.
Hello.
Hello, who's that?
It's Stephanie.
Hello, is that you who went in the background? Yeah. What, are you excited?
I am for Joel, yeah.
We're speaking to your brother! Come on, put him back on.
Alright, here he is.
Get on with it.
Oh. Joel?
Yeah?
How many people?
You're wasting a lot of time this morning, aren't you?
Three,
thanks, right, lovely. Okay, we got the teams, bungalow heads. He's with Joel. Joel picked three. Emily's with me. She picked five. If you back the right team, you'll get 80 bungalow points. Choose your team now!
Three! How many people? Oh, look at this. Many.
Oh, three choices.
Oops, no. Oh, dear. So whose team are you on? You're mine or Dick's?
Half.
Well, you can't go half. Who are you going to do?
Side of cash.
Quick, go.
Right, right. Okay, then, how many people on that bus? It's back. Melvin O'Doom. Rum, rum, ding, ding. Sings it. Bum, bum, bum.
So I need a word.
dancing dough, oh, oh, sing dough. And dear, she knows a dream, oh dear. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me a name I call myself. Far a long, long way to run.
My son, well done, well done, well done. Good job, good job.
Good job. Proud of you, Mel. Yeah.
Right. Well done, that means Joel and my team were the winners. Yeah! Yeah. Sanjay and David, well done, you're the winner of 80 Bungalow points each. Yeah. And Joel.
Hello.
You won.
Yeah.
Nice one, get him. We'll send you prizes in time for Christmas. Have a look, come over here.
This is what you win. This is what you win.
Look, there you go. Oh, you win that, 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 and that.
And Emily, do you know what you get for getting it wrong? Sing it, boys!
It's a remix!
It's a remix!
Diddly.
Hello, darling. Cary Grant here. Well, I think David's doing very well. He's been absolutely marvellous. He looks great. He sounds great. He is great. In fact, he impressed me so much I married him and now I wash his pants. Thrice weekly.
I'm a really good singer and you are not.
And now on Nick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Sit down. Sit.
Music! Thank you!
Dance around the sofa. Yes, yes. Okay.
Dash, come with me.
Off you go.
Would you like to, what do you think about this morning so far, Akash?
Great!
Never again. Into the loft! A yum yum yak! Oh, yes! Here we are. Sit there on the X. Put on your headband. Put on your wall paint. Here we go.
Oh, God. Using chocolate.
Can your wife's
you
here!
A winner?
I knew it!
Will you pick a saint?
She's here!
Or will you pick a sinner?
David!
Once full of dirty nasties like cackalack and yum, 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 yak.
Cary Grant, ladies and gentlemen! Your missus is here, mate! Oh, well, we've got a lift home anyway. Right, we got 12 chocolates on this spinny thing. 11 of them are yum-yum. One of them is yak. If you pick the yak chocolate, you're getting out. If you don't and I get it, you get... You need the points, don't you? How many do you want? How many?
500.
All right, then 500, sorted. It's a lot, that, isn't it?
It's a lot.
Bit less. 250, half of that, that'll do. Right, then. Okay. Remember, you've got to chomp the whole chocolate or chump it. Your choice. If it's yum yum, tell them that it's yum yum. If it's yak, tell them that it's yak. Right, you can go first. Spinny, spin, spin. Which number are you going for? Let's go for 12. Chomp it all up. Chomp it, chomp it.
Yum yum.
Oh! Clever, isn't he? Tactics, man, tactics. 4. Yum yum. Spin. Let's go for 11. Chomp it all. Every last bit.
Yum yum.
There's his stuff. Number 3. Yeah.
Final curtain falls on this epic test of skill. Oh, have you tasted sweet success or are you feeling rather ill? Oh, 3 cheers for the victor. You were
you've eaten, vomit what you've eaten.
Me and Dom basically told the bloke who made them it wasn't yak enough. Well, it is now. You get 250 Bungalow points, yeah! Akash! Well played, man, well played. Dom! It's yak, man!
Yeah!
Right, let's go and have a score check, see how the Bungalow heads are doing so far here on this wonderful Saturday morning, courtesy of the BBC. Courtesy of the BBC.
With 500, now he's just won that. Dalrag with 160, Sanjay with 148, Armadib with 89, and David with 181. Nice, Akash, you're winning now, mate.
There you are, look, Akash, there you are.
Wow.
Still up there.
Right, yeah, okay, look out for the word. The flyer's going to be holding up a word, and it's your chance to win a Bungalow T-shirt. We're going to sign it. Have a look. If you think you see it, then text us.
Nice. Also, find out where the prize it is.
We're going to have a cup of tea. Will your missus make us a cup of tea, David?
Yeah, go
we'll
on,
get her out of the loft and get her to make us a cup of tea. Right.
Carrie!
Program on.
Dick and Dom's dirty day in a bit too.
You know, means I can't remember the last
and the secret word there was SWAT. The winner is Owen Winter from Wadebridge in
SWAT.
Cornwall. You win a T-shirt with SWAT written on it.
SWAT!
Cary Grant here. David Grant there. He's my husband. He wakes me up every morning by dipping my hand in a cup of cold cocoa and smoothing my hair with a greasy leg of lamb. It's a laugh a minute round at our house.
I'm a really good singer and you are not.
You gotta listen out for this gap. It's a famous neighbor. Don't clap. Something like Sebastian Coe. Celebrity two-word tango.
Oh, is that it? Oh, that's in the extended version.
Sure.
Two-word tango time, you're going to hear a piece of music with a break in the music. When you hear the break, you have to put a celebrity's word in the break.
Name.
Name. In the break. Thank you, Tim. You can't have a fictional person's name, like Phil Mitchell, but it can be Steve McFadden. Otherwise, you'll hear that. Right, no repeats, and don't pauses as well. Don't miss the beats. Let's play two-word tango.
Starting off at the end with David.
Barbara Windsor.
Very good.
Steven Gerrard. Black Eyed Peas.
Black Eyed Peas.
It's a group name.
Henri.
Sharon Osbourne.
Very good.
50 Cent.
Very good.
Thierry Henry.
Hang on a minute, hang on a minute.
Already.
Did you already say Thierry Henry?
You said, no, he said Henry.
Who said it?
And he said 50 Cent.
No, 50 Cent. He said 50 Cent. I said 50 Cent.
Yeah, that's okay. That's his real name.
First I said 50 Cent and then you said
You said 50 Cent.
I didn't
hear you. Yeah. And then both of you said both out.
Oh, no, 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 what's happened? Shut up, stop. Right. Well, we didn't hear 50 Cent. We heard Thierry Henry. Sorry, Dalraj.
We
get taken away. Come on, you're right, you've got to vocalise your names, nice and loud.
Starting off with Perva, you ready? Two, we're tango.
Michael Owen.
Yes.
Very good. Nice and loud.
Henri.
Oh, you missed the beat.
Henri.
Move on up.
Henry.
Yeah, well, that's it, mate, you're out.
Give me that. Nothing.
There, right.
Starting off.
You could do so much better.
Two-word tango.
Akon.
Akon, yeah, good.
Kelly Osbourne.
Yeah,
very good. Got right one.
Dick and Dom.
Yeah, very good. Yeah.
I'm not really listening.
Oh!
What happened? You've been removed.
Don't forget, if you win this, you're going to get 333 Bungalow points.
You all need this. Right then, Armadie, ready? To a tango.
Rachel Stevens.
Yes.
No, oh, yeah. Popular favourite.
Sean Paul.
Cary Grant.
Oh, yes.
Daniel Radcliffe.
Yeah. Very good.
Steven Gerrard.
Yeah.
Bruce Forsyth. Someone else has Steven Gerrard.
Danny Homer.
Yeah.
Milan Barros.
Yeah. Hold on. Somebody else said Steven Gerrard.
Oh, but they said it in another round, so it's I'm sorry.
So you can say the same things over and
Listen,
over again.
He's making up excuses.
You've explained the rules.
Get off! Get off! Come on!
And didn't he explain the rules beautifully, eh? Right then. Armadie, two win tangos. Just between two of you for 330 points. Go!
Steven Gerrard.
Yeah.
Windsor.
Oh, hang on. Yeah, it doesn't
Michael Owen.
Oh, no, it is a bit.
Milan Barros.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh! Yes! Well, Akash, yes! You've just got to watch yourself 330 bungalow points. Yay! Nicely played. And David Grant would like a word with you, Dom.
How can you keep on saying the same names over and over again? That's rubbish. This is a rubbish game. You're supposed to keep coming up with new names.
The rules of the game are simple. In each round, you cannot pause, you cannot repeat a celebrity's name, and you cannot...
But they repeated celebrities' names!
That's enough of that, it's Strangely Talented!
Roll up, roll up, it's time to meet Strangely Talented, they're unique. Roll up, roll up.
Up as we go along, David. No, it's Strangely Talented time. We got three more strange acts. We had three last week, and the winner of the rounds will come back and be in the grand final to win. Look at it.
The mounted fruitcake.
Nutty fruitcake.
Well, nutty mounted fruitcake.
It's mounted and it's nutty.
What fun's he got, is it?
What? Right then, let's get on with it. The first act here on Strangely Talented on Divadom and Bungalow. Strangely Talented, Saturday morning, ready for the bank for the It's Zanny the human beatboxer. All right, mate. Okay, now, whilst he's doing his talent, you have to write down your scores and your comments.
Oh, he's got his bottle of water.
Very good.
Marvellous, yes. Here we go.
Let's just start. Yeah, well, yeah, in your own time, fire away.
Cool. First thing to say, happy birthday to baby Carl, 1 year old today.
All right, come on, get on with it.
Deduct points from that. Happy birthday to Ashley Bailey, who's 8 as well, yeah.
And can I just say, shut up and get on with it.
Yo. One, two, three, four, hit it, fit it.
Unreal!
Fantastic,
man. Right, okay, let's.
Points.
Go on then.
Minus 100!
Don't get the idea. Minus 100, don't get the idea!
Hey?
Come on, man, he was amazing! Come on, let's have a look. Further.
50.
My mum can sing better.
He wasn't trying
to sing. He was beatboxing, not singing. So that's 50 so far. No, it's minus 50. 100.
Yeah.
Sick bruh.
Yeah.
What's sick bruh?
Wicked.
What is sick bruh?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Young and talk, eh? Yes. Sick bruh. So that means very good. Yeah. You little scallywag. So that's 50 points so far.
100.
Yeah. 100. Very good.
Ooh, nice.
Come on, he's got to get more points than that. 50. Halfway. Halfway to what? Halfway to being stupid. That's not very nice. The man's a talent. David.
60 out of 100. Chronic. That's good.
Chronic. Ah, young and tall. Yeah, hang on.
But there is medicine for that stutter.
Oh, there. All right, then. There's medicine for that stutter. So how many?
260. And 60 for Zany the human people. That's a good score, mate.
Oh, brilliant.
Thank you very much. You made it back for the final.
See you later.
We'll be after our second act on here on Diggin' Up and the Bungalow. The second act on Saturday morning is Auntie Julie's balloon tree. My word, what's this going on?
Here's Auntie Julie with a balloon and her kids.
Yes,
marvellous.
Hello, Auntie Julie.
Hello, Auntie Julie.
Hiya.
All right.
Right, we're going to show you a trick. I'm going to show you a trick, but it's a dangerous trick. This is Dom's head. I'm going to put a needle all the way through Dom's head.
Ah. Hang on a minute.
We're going to go through his hair, through his skull, through his brain and out through his neck. Are you ready?
Nice. How lovely. Oh, she's wobbling.
We are all the way through.
He's gone through!
His head.
And my head has popped.
And just to prove that his head is nothing but hot air.
It's too easy.
There you go. Oh, look. And they all jumped on their balloons at the same time.
And have another go. Brilliant. Oh. Auntie Julie and her balloon
trick. Auntie Julie, a good trick. Good to have another magician on the show. Right then. Okay, let's get your scores.
21. I've seen it before.
Oh, where did you see it before?
At
home. I can do it myself.
Oh, you can do it yourself? What do you think about that? He can do it himself.
A magician in the making.
A magician in the making. Perva, turn it around.
2,000.
2,000? No, you can't do that. 100. Sorry, 100's the highest score. Try again. Yeah. Write another score. Yes, you have to mark out 100. Yeah. Go on. No, that's 2001
wait,
now.
There.
No, that's we said less.
There.
Oh, what?
0.01. No, this way round.
What, 100?
100!
Yes. Well, hang on, what do you want to put? How much do you want to give her, Perva? How many?
400.
No, you can't give them
100.
She liked the balloon trick. What's this? What, minus one. My granny can do a better trick, cooking.
Cooking. Good job, I'm not a cook.
Does she do that trick whilst cooking?
Yeah.
That's clever. What a clever granny you have.
Can I read mine?
You, oh, yes, you'd like to read yours. Of course you can.
Zero.
Armady.
Zero, rubbish. That's rubbish. If I wanted to see balloons, I would have a party.
Did you hear that?
I thought this was a party.
Right? So nothing. And, Dalaraj. Five. What are you doing? What are you doing? So there we are. Finally.
Oh, they're confusing. 70 for Dom's destruction.
Oh.
Minus 60 for the act. But 20 for the kids.
Yes. Oh, which makes it 30.
30.
Like
what's
it.
What's the score, Dom?
Thank you.
What's the score, Dom?
30.
155. So thank you very much, Auntie Julie.
Thank you, Auntie Julie. And bye-bye, little people. Bye.
Still in the lead is Zana the Human Beatboxer, but will Act 3 on Strangely Talented on Nick and Dominic on Saturday morning, will they be back for the final? We're going to find out now because it is K9 Freestyle Dance.
Come on in.
K9 Freestyle Dance.
The dog's got a shaved butt.
But why?
Oh, poppin' I know, poppin' I know. One's chicken ears a clean show. Thought I ever gonna whoa. See no poppin' I know. You ever gonna see so poppin' and smoke? Oh, poppin' I know, poppin' I know. One's chicken ears a clean show. Thought I ever gonna see no poppin' I know. You ever gonna see so poppin' and smoke?
We better stop there. Stop. Get it down. Stop. See? Look, we just wanted to see a strange talent, not
it's,
that.
It's a K9 freestyle dance. What do you reckon out of 100?
Go then. At cash. 100.
For the outfit.
For the outfit. He likes your cowboy outfit. Well, you might have been watching the dog. Herbert.
10. Seen him before.
Seen him before? Where have you seen that before? I've never seen that before.
In the circus.
Do you go to the circus?
No, I don't.
You know, he doesn't. All right, so next.
50.
A freestyle is a rap.
That was number one.
Young person's talk again.
Yes.
Amadeev, I'll say you don't like me reading your comments. Go on.
All right, Zero, you think you can dance. My granny can do the moonwalk.
Oh, his granny can do the moonwalk.
Dalaraj,
yeah, you want to read it again? Okay, I'll put me out of a job.
99 because it was good, and minus one because you shaved the dog's back.
Oh, we didn't like shaving the dog.
Not really his back, it's more like his butt.
We don't like to shave the mutt. What?
Bum, yeah.
Right, next. Not calling you nutty, sorry. A dancing dog with a bare butt. 60 for the dog, minus 40 for the butt.
Oh,
so that's 20.
So the total being 279. You are the winner, K9 Freestyle Dance. There you are. Will you come back here Christmas for the final?
Would you like to sniff fruitcake? Sniff it.
You could win that.
There is the winner of Strange and Talented this week. It's K9 Freestyle Dance.
See you later. Bye bye. Off you go.
Marvellous. Another round of that. Next week.
Hang on, it's just coming in. Wait, look.
This way, please, ladies, this way. Coming through. Move along, please.
Hello.
This is the Dick and Dom's bungalow, and this is Dick and Dom. Hello, boys.
Hello.
You all right?
Yeah, not bad.
Yes,
thanks.
This way, please, girls.
What is it?
Just to let you know that this was a very strange and talented game, but I bet you haven't seen anything quite as strange and talented as this. Hit it.
Oh, I'm just wild about Harry, and he's just wild about me. The heavenly blisses of his kisses fills me with ecstasy. He's sweet just like chocolate candy, and like the heavens from above. Oh, I'm just wild about Harry, 'cause he's just wild about, cannot live without, he's just wild about me. Yeah!
Scores out of 100!
Thank you, this way, ladies. Thank you, thank you.
Bye. Bye, ladies.
Thank you.
Bye, ladies.
Yeah. Wow, BBC tours have got exciting these days, haven't they?
Are they going to do the clack?
Usually they stand in the donut and do that.
Right, well, thank you for that. So you are, another round of Strangely Talented next week. Yes. Oh, Raymond Newsreader's here with an update.
Morning, Raymond, News, Even Stevens. Ren stuck in lift, trying to get to meet Ruby. That's all. Look out for word, text, email, T-shirt could be yours! Back to action!
It's sticking up in the Bungalow Saturday morning with Happy Bungalow Heads! And
happy David Grant!
Look at him, Abby, and we're still here for another
And also a happy Katie, who's won the competition. She saw the fly on the screen, hurry up a word.
Yes.
Katie, Dick, Dom.
Fly! You've been texting and emailing this morning as well. Another prize to give away. It's from Amy and Beth. They say, we cannot read or write, but we can drive tractors. Well, that's lovely.
So that's one, and we've got another one as well. That's an email. Why not? Why not?
Because we ain't got time.
No, we have got time. Well, the time we spent arguing about it, I could have read it out already. What a stupid waste of time!
Ooh. Hello there, and welcome to Diddy Spell. Yes, where the stars of today's show are friend off the pink cupboard, Diddy Dick. Yes. And the friend of little people everywhere, Diddy Dom.
Thank you. Hold on a minute, Lovie. Oh. What have you come dressed as? As a wizard, ready for the spell quiz.
Spell quiz is not a spell quiz, it's a spelling quiz.
Yes. Oh, I feel so foolish.
No, lie. Let's begin. Diddy Dick.
Yes.
Mississippi is a very big river, but can you spell it?
I-T-it.
Correct. Well done. Excellent. Very, very good. Very good. Very good. Diddy Dom.
Yes.
Can you spell bungalow?
Oh, bungalow. B-U-N-G-A-L. O-H. Bungalow!
No. Bungalow. B-U-N-G-A-L-O-W. Bungalow.
Oh, is that how they say it in the dictionary, is it?
Yes, in the dictionary.
Well, you didn't ask me to say how it's spelled in the dictionary. Oh, right, okay, here's one for you then. Spell rabbit.
Rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit.
My dad gave me a cheap dictionary for my birthday, lovey.
Oh, yeah?
Couldn't find the words to thank him.
Thanks for watching Diddy Spell. That's all, folks. Remember, spelling's always compelling. Can I have a carrot, please?
Here's what the Bungalow points look like for the Bungalow Heads at the moment. I'm dicking on with the Bungalow. They've been earning them since 9 o'clock, and Perva's got 102.
Yes, indeed. Cash has got 833. What a great score.
Dalred with 116. Remember, the prizes will all be given away just before 11 during the
next
month.
Page, we've got Sanjay with 148.
Armadine with 89.
And David's got 181. Who's going to lose and who's going to win? We just don't know. Who's going to win so
who's
far?
Win?
You think you're going to win? Can you stop breaking our flipping doors?
I've been making some door-to-door inquiries. You like that? Right, shut it. Nothing's funny around here, right? Now then, there's somebody here that's holding out on me. Isn't that right, Armadeep? Eh? So it's time to go down the station for a bit of interrogation.
I've got your bank to rights and you're coming down the station. I'll have myself a cuppa, then I'll start interrogation. If I didn't spot your secret words in the interview, I'll have to drop the charges, give you points, then you gear away.
Welcome to the interrogation room here in the bungalow. How are you feeling? Nervous?
No, I'm okay.
Oh, can you pretend to be nervous?
Yeah.
Good, thanks.
I'm going to give you a secret word. DC Harry Bat's going to come in here and then interrogate you for 90 seconds. Okay. Every time you manage to say this word in the 90 seconds, you will bank yourself 20 bungalow points. The idea is he doesn't know and will not guess what the word is. So you can use other words as a distraction, okay, or you can just stick to trying to drop your word in every now and then. Okay. If he guesses after the 90 seconds what your word is, then he will sentence you to the pants dance and you'll get nothing. However, if he doesn't guess correctly, then you will win all those banked up points. Remember, 20 points for every time you mention the word.
Okay.
All right, so here is the word. Don't say it, because he might be listening. There's the word. Okay, you've got to try and mention that, all right? Ah!
This interview starts now. Right, Sunshine. We know you've done it. So you better start squealing, right? Let's sort this out. I want to know exactly what you were doing last night.
I was at home playing on my guitar.
They all say that. Carry on.
Okay, I was playing on my guitar and then my brother came in and he started bashing on the piano, and...
Bashing on the piano?
Yes.
What's that about?
He just started bashing on the piano.
Bashing on the piano and you were playing the guitar?
Yes.
Right, go on. What happened next?
Next, my brother, he got in trouble and the piano was broken, so I had to play the guitar all night. And then off... Then the next day I went to school and I had guitar lessons. And then after that...
Guitar lessons, eh?
Yeah, and after that I had piano lessons.
Yeah.
And then I came home, started playing, watching TV, went to sleep, went to school, guitar lessons, piano lessons.
So it's all about guitar lessons, is it?
Yes.
I don't know whether I'm believing this or not, son. I can't make head or tail of it. Pianos, guitars, right. For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing the suspect, Exhibit A, a small flowery bap. What have you got to say about that then, eh?
It's tasty.
It's tasty? Does it play the piano?
No.
Does it play the guitar?
Yes.
It does? Look, son, what's the word? Just tell me. We can cut a deal.
Time up, time up. Please leave him alone. He's been through enough. Now, are you going to charge my client or are you going to release him? What's the word, Batman?
Piano.
Let's have a look.
Touch back again. Right, son. Here you go. You've got to put theirs
You've got
on
your head. Mojo back.
Got to put theirs on your head. Away we go, son. Serve your time like a man. You can't be a good, decent Geordie cop. Keep going. You'll
no.
be entertained with
no.
his pleasure and his pleasure.
No, don't. No, don't. No, keep them.
There you go, son, join your mates.
Yes, you are losing, so you are going to do the pants dance. Come on, Albany, I got my hands on my hands.
Nice one.
I got a groovy disco trance. Who's been clean on just last week? Oh, yes, but... Yeah, yeah, baby, look at me.
Dance in your pants.
He's not happy about it.
He's not happy.
You did well though in the game.
You did do well.
You did do good.
You did do very well. Becky, who's 7, and Brad, who's 4, doing the pants dance while watching Muckbusters. That was our game on Muckmuck.
What?
A few weeks ago.
What?
What?
Somebody say my name?
What?
Did you say my name?
I didn't say your name.
Lauren and Nathan doing the pants dance. It's Lauren's birthday on Monday. Happy birthday. I love this song. Imagine if you could just buy it.
What?
Wouldn't that be great?
Right, let's have a look.
Well done, you'll get them.
Heads, bungalow points now on Dick and Dom in the bungalow. Because the prizes they're playing for are going to be these in third...
What? Cross!
None!
None!
Hot cross none is third prize.
Yes, yes, you second can win
prize.
That.
Second prize, an MP3 player. MP3 player, second prize.
First what? Prize.
Look at first prize. It's going to be just before 11. Who's going to get it? Look at it. Look at it.
Look at him!
This weekend's winning bungalow head will get the experience of a lifetime! It's an amazing skydiving day out! A simulated skydive at Milton Keynes! And to top it off, we're giving you a digital camera to take pickies of your day! You'll be the envy of all your skydiving wannabe mates!
Yeah, but let's find out who the,
What?
Scores are. Let's have a look at the scores here for the Bungalow Heads here on Dick and Dom the Bungalow. We're halfway through the morning at 102 points for Perva.
Akash with 833. Come on, lad.
Dalraj has got 160.
And on the next page, Sanjay with 148.
And 89 for Harmony.
And David with 181. But it could all change during bookmarking.
And it could also change during the next game, which is Tunnel of Tug of War.
Spent all week in playgroup, so they need to let off steam. They're going to throw a tantrum if they're on the losing team. The winners will stand tall with the losers on the floor. So take the strain and heave for the toddler tug of war.
Norwich, which team are you going to go for? The talent show judges with Dom, those toddlers, or the bunny rabbits with me? Choose your team now!
Go on.
Who's going to win the tug of war?
Oh, no, they've already chosen. No, they're not. They're changing.
They're choosing again.
They're going with me. No, they're not. There you go. There so you just got one. You got Dalraj. I've got all the rest. So let's, without any further ado, meet.
Him.
Oh, David swapped as well.
Right every time so far.
Right. Well, fair enough. Well, let's meet the competitors as they come through. First of all,
toddlers.
The bunny rabbits. Come back.
So here come today's toddlers. There's a little bunny there. That's Callan, known as Lip Up Fatty.
Oh.
Here's toddler number two. Here, lovely bunny rabbit. It's Kaleshi, known as Sweaty Chops. Here's the third lady this morning, it's Lucy, known as the Bone Crusher.
And now let's meet the talent show judges as they come through here.
Yes, here come the talent show judges. This is Anisha, or Cyclopa Ball, as she likes to know, be known.
Next!
Talent show judge here. This is Alia, or Snaggletooth.
Along you come.
And here's our next talent show judge. She's coming up here. It's Giovanni.
Oh.
And Giovanni likes to be known as Clopsy Mopsy Yashmak. Terror personified.
Okay, right, Bungalows, we've got our team sorted out. And please welcome our adjudicator for today. It's Mr. Melvin O'Doom. Not his dad, but the real guy.
And remember, it's going to be the best out of three. So
and the winner will get...
The winner will get 225.
There you go. Melvin O'Doom, over to you. Everyone, keep off the blue mat, please. Keep off the blue mat and stick to your teams.
All right, then, kids. On my whistle, you will pull as hard as you can. Ready, steady...
So here we go. These toddlers all... Oh, it's over already. Incredible.
So that's 1 point to the talent show judges. Melvin O'Doom, back to you.
Take your positions, take your positions. Ready? Grab the rope.
No, no helping. Take the strain, buddies.
Ready?
Melvin,
hang on.
Can you grab hold of the rope? We're just going to get the buddies settled out because they're a bit confused. It's Christmas, not Easter.
Okay, you ready there? Okay. On my whistle, you pull as hard as you can. Ready?
So here we go. The bunny rabbits have really got to steal it back. But no, the talent show judges have taken it already.
It's over! So there we are. There we have it. Akash, Armadi, Purva and Sanjay all get 225 bungalow points each.
One.
The talent show judges are the winners. There's the prizes. Dom, award them. Award them. There we are. And
Nicely.
Not forgetting the bunnies as well.
Put the rope down. Grab your toys.
Let's go with your bunny.
Grab your toys.
There we are.
Come here. Hop over here. Bounce.
Hop.
Boing. Now look, you are very nice and white. What's your name? You're all covered in white like we were when we did Dick and Dom's Dirty Day. And the idea was to get as dirt there. The idea was to get as dirty as we possibly can. Would you like to do it? Yes, well, that can be arranged. Here's some tips.
Welcome to Birkenstead for another Dick and Dom's Dirty Day.
Yes, we've got half an hour, just 30 minutes, 30 minutes, to try and get as dirty as we possibly can. And the one who's most dirty at the end of 30 minutes will be the winner. Let's go and get really, really dirty. See you in half hour, darling. Can you buy a milkshake and come out and throw it in my face? Is that all right? I'll pay you back.
Hello. You're a hairdresser, yes?
Yeah.
You got any hair dye to make me dirty?
I don't know, maybe.
10 minutes have passed. Still no milkshake.
I don't want a blue rinse.
That's it. And there, lovely. What colour's that?
purple, lovely. A bit of purple on the leg. Yeah, green, great.
Started well, hasn't it, eh?
Right, that's it. I've had enough of waiting. I'm going to go.
Spray me trousers brown. Make me dirty. Yeah. Dirty. And me back. Actually, do me all.
Damn straight down there.
Late. Dirty.
Dirty.
Oh, look, you've got my milkshakes. Just tip it over my head. Or just throw it in my face.
Oh,
whatever.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's so cold! What about the other one? Oh, my face has gone numb! My nose! I'm just gonna...
Someone buy a cream bun and stick it all over me. Is it an apple horn?
Dirty little monkeys.
Dirty. You dirty, dirty, dirty little monkeys.
I'll just stand by the tree, and if you could just throw it at my face. God, do it more. All over me. Come on, so I've got to get more dirty than dick. Any west behind.
Still 15 minutes to go though.
Have you got any shampoo things pouring over my head?
Shampoo?
Or anything really. Just because I need to get dirty and I'm not dirty enough.
Is that permanent?
No.
Is that hair colour? What are you doing? Go on now, give it a good rinse. Come on, give me a massage. Oh, that's lovely. That's lovely. Ah, yes. I'm looking for some oil. Right. Oh, that's lovely, a bit on my leg. My knee's a bit stiff.
Taste of shampoo!
My eyes!
Hey, we've got some in here. She's buying me something.
What is it? What is it? It's a chili baked potato! You dirty little monkey!
There's a hard-boiled egg down there in the water. Do you mind getting it and rubbing it on my head?
What, rub it?
Go on, rub it. Go on. Ah! Eggy head! Whilst we're at it, you might as well just grab my hand and pull me through the puddle. Is that right? Well, grab my hand and just pull me through the puddle.
Dirty bottom. Dirty bottom.
It's cold! It's reacting with something! Chemical fusion. He's coming back. Time's up.
Chili con carne.
Help him! Somebody!
You won again!
Yeah!
2-1 to Dom! Dirty boy!
Wasn't I dirty?
Oh, excuse me, the phone's
yes.
ringing. I'll just go and get
go
the phone.
To the vestibule.
Excuse me a moment.
Vestibule time.
2 seconds, I'll just go around here and
get... Ooh, flash, isn't it? Look at that!
Go in here.
That looks flash.
Magic. Hello, Dick and Dom at the bungalow. Who's there? Hello,
it's Dick. It's the Almighty Kid!
The telephone rang.
Yes.
Picked it up.
Who was it?
Said hello's there. They said,
it's the Almighty Kid!
It's the Almighty Kid! Hang on a minute. Go back. Speak to them.
Magic. Yes, Almighty Kid, who would you like to give points to or take them away from?
122 points to a cash.
Stay there. Points to a cash. Yes. Oh, I didn't ask why. Hold on. Magic. Why?
Because your toilet likes to get messy.
Ow! Because you like to get messy at cash. You get 100 bungalow points. Do you want to go and speak to them?
Yes.
Don't say thanks. Don't forget to wave.
And your phone.
Remember and to say magic. Go in. Magic.
Hello? Hello.
Hello.
Thank you for giving me the bungalow points.
You're welcome.
Okay, then, bye.
But wasn't that nice? And now time for Looney Tunes. What are you doing, man?
I don't really know.
Just go down there, quick. Muck muck in a bit, then we'll find out who the winner is.
The secret word there was swamp. The winner is Jess Patel from Longbridge in Birmingham. You've got a T-shirt with swamp on it.
Swamp!
It's the Creamy Muck Muck Grand Finale. The crunch, the decider, the ultimate test. To sort out the winners, the saints from the sinners, the weak from the chaff and the best from the rest. Will you be able to capitalise or win the amazing first place prize?
This week's well-rotted down, mulchy, wet, pa-quanky knack. A question of muck.
And now, it's a question of muck with your host, Sue Mucker.
Well, good morning. Welcome to A Question of Muck. Let's meet the teams. Over here, the prize winners, captained by Dick. And in first place, we've got Akash. He's standing to win a skydiving day out, which is very exciting. In second place is Sanjay, who's going to win a portable MP3 player and CD. Mm. And in third place, winning a hot cross nun, is Perva. But of course, that could all change. If the prize losers win a question of muck, then they could steal all those prizes. Ooh. And here are the prize losers. Team captain, of course, is Dominic there.
Hello. Good evening.
In fourth place, Amadeep. In fifth place, TV's David Grant. And in sixth place is Dalraj. So, without further ado, let's get right on to round one. It's the picture board round. Okay, we all know the rules of this. We have a look at a picture, that's nice. But of course, we've got to guess, because it's a quiz, isn't it? So the prize winners first. Let's guess who's in this picture. Oh, you've got to pick a number. I'm so sorry, love. I'm off with the fairies this morning. I'm all at sixes and sevens. My car broke down in the car park, and my dog's very poorly as well. So pick a number.
It's all that jigging about. Which number are we going for? Should we go for...
Two.
We're going for number two. So.
You're saying number two. Let's have a look at it.
What do you think that is?
It's frightening, whatever it is.
It's a prize idiot.
It's a what?
I think it's prize idiot.
Okay. All right, we think it's the prize idiot, Sue.
Well, let's take a look.
Is it the prize idiot?
No, there we are. So, unfortunately, you could have had 1 point there. You got no points. That was, in fact, Danny Harmer, the World Cup winner from New Zealand. Over to the losers. Pick a number, please, Tom.
I think we'll have number three, please, Sue.
Number three.
I didn't get 30.
Let's have a look at number three.
I didn't get
30. 1 point to you, Dom, and the losers, if you can tell me who that is.
Very
different. That's easy, that one.
Yeah, I think we've got it. Chris Moyles.
Let's have a look. Let's see if it is Chris Moyles.
Yeah!
1 point to the losers. Very well done. Now we're moving right on to round two, which is what happened next. So, of course, you all know the rules to this. We play you a little bit of videotape and then we stop it and you have to tell us what happened next. It literally couldn't be simpler. So, prize winners,
yes?
Here comes your clip.
OK. By school day, I'm a mere five-year-old boy, but on a Saturday and Sunday morning, I become... Pants Man! There he is, look. The most incredible young boy to don a pair of pants.
Well... There we go, the videotape's paused there. That's a clip from Dick and Dom in the bungalow. What do you think happened next, winners?
I think we've got it. I think that Pants Man arrives in the bungalow and does some mad business.
OK, Pants Man arrives in the bungalow and does some mad business. Let's have a look. Well, you can see that there is the Pants Man. Oh, look at him. And there he's having a little fight with you. So, yes, you were right.
Well done.
Very well done. You, of course, get 1 point for that. So well done to you, prize winners. Let's see if the prize losers can get a point in this round. It's all terribly exciting. Here comes your clip.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, there we go.
What do we think? I can't guess because I actually know the answer.
But he guessed.
Well, what do you think? Well, he's a naughty man. Don't listen to him.
Be as naughty as him.
I told him the answer.
No, you did.
Come along. It's a quiz, not a jamboree.
A big person.
A big dressed up person comes up.
Okay, that's what you're saying. Let's have a look.
Yeah.
Yes! Yes! Nice one!
There is a big person scaring the children. Classic Saturday morning telly, I think.
That child near keels over is what happened.
I think we can all agree he was having a tremendous amount of fun. So that's 1 point to you. Well done, prize losers. So let's go into our final round, the home and away round. Okay, so of course, in this round, you have to choose if you're going to go home and away. A home question will get you 1 point, an away question will give you 2 points. Home, of course, is about the bungalow. Away is general knowledge. Who's first? I think it's Akash. Are you going home or away?
Home.
Home question. Okay, for 1 point, the prize idiot is known as Roger by Dick and Dom. True or false? I've got to hurry you.
Could you just guess?
True.
No, it's not true. He's known as the prize idiot. Incorrect. No points to you there. Sanjay, are you going home and away?
Hello, Sanjay. Home.
Okay, home question. What creature in the bungalow, for 1 point, what creature in the bungalow throws up every Saturday morning?
Crocodile.
That's correct. The crocodile, 1 point to you. Okay, Perva, are you going home or away?
Home.
You're going home, okay. Words made up by bungalow heads go in the dick and what?
Dictionary.
The Domshimmery, correct. Another point to you, prize winners. Very well done, holding your lead. Okay, moving. Oh no, Dick, you have to go away.
Okay.
Not literally, of course, that would be ridiculous. We need you to go away, so your away question is, what sport is Thierry Henry famous for playing?
Footers, football.
Football it is. Well done to you. Another point to the prize winners. Really are holding on very well. Over to you guys over here, the prize losers.
Yep.
Starting with Dal Raj, are you going home or away? Home for you. Okay, your home question is, Harry Batt is a window cleaner, true or false?
False.
It is false. 1 point to you, the losers. Very well done. David, are you going home or what? You're going away. Mm-hmm. Right, have an away question for you for 2 points. What grows in a paddy field?
Rice.
Rice is correct. 2 points. Very well played. Tactically playing there. And here we get Armadeep. Are you going home or away? You're going home. Okay, a home question for you. What would Dick and Dom often shout in museums and libraries?
Bogies.
Bogies is the correct answer. Very well done, 1 point to you. Dominic, you two have to go away. Thank goodness, I thought it would never happen. What are Jamie Oliver and Gordon Ramsay, apart from men, because that's easy?
What are they?
Yes, what are they? What do they do for a job?
They're cooks. They're chefs.
They're chefs, that's absolutely right. Well done, well played to you. 2 points to you. Lovely, right. We've just got time to go back to the picture board. That is traditional on the question of Muck. So prize winners, pick a number even.
Oops, hooray!
Which number would you like?
Yes, we'll pick a number. One or four, winners. Anything, four.
Four, let's have a look at four. There it goes.
Okay, that's, who do you think that is? I think, no, go on, do you know?
I want you to say it.
All right, it's Bruce Forsyth.
Let's have a look. Is it Bruce Forsyth? No.
Oh,
it's Tony Christie, last week's guest from the bungalow. So, OK, unfortunately, no points to you. Losers, obviously, you have to have number one. Let's have a look at it. Flip it round.
Oh, that's easy.
Adam Woodyatt.
Yeah,
go on, David knows.
Adam Woodyatt, who plays
Ian Beale
in EastEnders.
It's Adam Woodyatt. Let's have a look. It is Adam Woodyatt.
Yeah!
Another friend of the bungalow. The losers, I believe, have won.
Yes!
Okay, so the winners got five, the losers got nine, the losers have stolen the prizes. That's extraordinary, very sporting. All that remains for me to say is thank you very much to all our guests. And go, 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 go!
Yeah! Here we go, Abby! Come on, Abby! on, man.
Prizes. So in third place, Dalreg. You got third place. You got the hot cross nun.
Where are the prizes?
Second prize was David. You got the MP3 player. But the winner of Dick and Dominic
Pumper. Who's third?
Was Armadeep.
Yeah!
No,
third was Dalreg.
That's first.
There you are, you win all that.
No, right, no, because, listen, David, because you managed to get a second prize, which is the MP3 player, we're going to now give that to a caller. Hello, caller.
Hello.
Who is it?
Hello.
Who's that?
Lauren.
Hello, Lauren. Look, say hello to David.
Hello.
Hello, Lauren.
David, you've now got to give that prize to Lauren. Go on, give it. Give it.
Lauren, this is yours. It's Lauren Cunningham from Egbert in Liverpool.
MP3 player.
MP3 player.
Nice to go.
There you go. That's for you.
All these bungalow heads will be back tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock on the CBBC channel. Be there.
How exciting. There. We'll see you next week as well on BBC One. Cheers, David. What a star.
Hello, darling. Now go away.
Top of the Pops reloaded is up very shortly and you are in control.